Hey guys, press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Pinkvilla.
Hi guys, this is Ragini Khanna and now I'm going to be sharing with you my skin and hair care regime. With me, it's all about being natural, it's all about being organic. Skin is the largest organ of our body, so it has to be taken care of immensely. And according to me, everything is dependent on internal health and genetics. So if genetically you have less hair on your head, don't expect it to be like really voluminous as much as you see it in the commercial. That's not going to happen. But yes, you can achieve the best your body can give. So the idea is to reach your best potential and not compare it to someone else, and embracing your own flaws and loving yourself for exactly who you are and what you are. So my skin is normal dry. In winters, it's extremely dry. So I start off with having a lot of water because I completely believe in internal health, which reflects in your external beauty as well. So keep hydrated, have a lot of fiber, have a lot of fresh fruits, have a lot of coolants. Something which is really good for your skin is kokum. Have little kokum water once in a 2-3 days or something. Have nareel pani, which is really good for your tender coconut is really good. Yeah, then for products, you wake up, you do your cleansing, toning, moisturizing. Then whichever product suits your skin, it's recommended if you go to a dermatologist and get a product which helps your skin type. And according to the climatic conditions of your country, many a times we take products which are very expensive, but they belong to somebody to a country which survives in extreme cold conditions. So those products are made for those country people. Our country is a hot country. We are supposed to wear products which suit our climate. So then after moisturizing, sunblock is a must. The cleanser would be a normal face wash, like a Kiehl's face wash. My moisturizer would be emoline. It's just right. It's not very sticky. Then I mix two sunblocks. One is a lotus herbal sunblock with the Kiehl's sunblock. I mix the two together and I apply it because the lotus one makes my skin too dry. Then if I have to use a face wash, then it's the Kiehl's face wash. I swear by Kiehl's most of the time. Then I also love forest essentials. They are my most favorite products because they're all Ayurveda and organic and really, really helpful for my skin type. Then makeup is something I use my own. I use a Giorgio Armani base. Then the powder which I use to dab on it is the Givenchy. And basically keep your brushes clean, keep your sponge, keep your eye makeup like really clean. Your brushes have to be like really clean so you don't get any infection. Another important tip is don't sleep with your makeup on. It's the first thing you can do to your skin. For me, the first thing I do after I get up from work or after I'm done with my meeting is clean my makeup and use something which is good for your skin. Initially, I started using makeup removers, but that kind of dried my skin even further. So for me, what works the best is baby oil or any of the makeup removing oils which we get in any market. It's not necessary that it has to be a very expensive product. It has to be what your skin needs. So yeah, clean your face, remove your makeup correctly, especially for women because we use liner, there's so much of mascara, all of that, and then wash your face and then moisturize it and go to sleep. For me, my night creams are very important. I use the Shiseido under eye night cream. Then that's something I do regularly. So homemade remedies for me for my face would be multani mitti with rose water once in a month. That's it, because multani mitti also dries your face up a lot since I have normal dry skin. Then something I do often is for my hair, I take curd and I take egg, I mix it, I put it in my hair. It stinks a lot, but I just do it once a month. Then there's one more thing I do for my skin in case there is a tan. This is something which really works for me. You take besan, curd, lemon, tomatoes, mix all of them, make a paste out of it, apply it on your face and just leave it for like 15-20 minutes. You will genuinely see your skin getting rid of the tan, but don't do it a lot because it has citric acid, so which is again not too good for your skin. And something you should also do is have multivitamins, have vitamin E, have vitamin C, which is really good for your skin. Multivitamins are very important. So I have curly hair, and maintaining curly hair is really, really difficult. I always wish that I have straight hairs. They're so easy to maintain, right? You just brush it off when you're on the move. But I'm blessed with curly hair and I love my curls and I do not wish to straighten them ever. So I use a Sebastian shampoo. I use the Sebastian conditioner and I use the Sebastian hairstyling gel. It's not a gel exactly, it's a styling product. You just use it as much as the size of a pearl. It's like really little, and just apply it to your wet hair and just like scrunch it up and leave it just to dry. Initially I used to use a diffuser, but then I realized that there's no point putting heat or hair air in my head unless and until I'm not shooting. If I'm shooting, there's a lot of damage, there's a lot of heat products going on in my hair. So yeah, after that I just leave it like that and then they curl up automatically. I have to put heat in my hair. I make sure I put a heat resistant product, something which protects my hair from the heat. I do hair spa at least once in 15 days and I oil my hair once in 3 days. I've been raised on oiling my hair. My doctor tells me it's not good to oil your hair, but it's just something psychological. I just do it, and because I have colored hair, I've been recommended not to oil my hair, but that's something I just think it works for me, so I just do it. And in case you have dandruff, please use an anti-dandruff shampoo, because that's a very big issue with hair, you know, especially with women. I think there is a medical shampoo for dandruff. Please use that and keep your comb clean. Don't use other people's comb. Hygiene is an issue. Yeah. My pimple remedy would be just let it be. I don't touch it because I think the more you kind of do things to it, the more you get, you know, it just freaks you out further. So I don't freak out over anything. If there is a pimple, I let it stay. I let it live its lifespan and I let it go. I bid it goodbye whenever it has to go. I welcome it with open arms and I let it go with open arms. I just don't keep fidgeting with it. I just don't touch it. Don't touch it. And don't try to burst your pimples. It's the ugly. It's disgusting. Don't do it. And it will give you pits in your skin. Don't do it. And if you have an acne issue, please visit your dermatologist. And don't have pills for your skin. It's everything has got to do with your internal health. If your internal health is not correct, it's going to reflect on your skin. Trust me. The best remedy for your skin to glow is stay happy. If you're happy, you're going to glow like a tube light. You're like really going to glow. Stay happy, stay positive, because no matter what you do, no matter how many things you do, if you're not happy and content within, it's not going to reflect on your face or in your eyes. I just don't do anything which is unnatural to my body. I don't do surgeries. I don't do cosmetic products. I don't take any injections for my, no enhancers, no fillers, nothing. Just, even if you're dark skin tone, I love Indian skin tones. Just keep it like that. Just love yourself for who you are. Trust me, you're going to be the best version of yourself. Self-love is really, really, really the key to look beautiful. So yeah, that was me with my hair and skin tips. One last tip I'll give before signing off is, in the morning, if you can rub a tiny ice cube on your face before you apply makeup, it would be really beneficial, since it just lets go of all the bloating and it shuts your pores before you apply makeup. So that's a good tip. If you like these kind of videos and if you want to see more of them, like, share, subscribe, only on Pinkvilla. Sorry for the fumble, and lots of love, hugs and kisses.